Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 42. This week I'm taking a flat, dull photo and recapturing the saturated, dramatic view that I remember seeing from this vantage point in St. Kitts. I begin in Lightroom, then move into Nick Google programs or Google Nick programs and end up doing selective adjustments back in Lightroom with graduated filter, radial filters, and the adjustment brush. So first let's begin in the basic panel of Lightroom, and I'm going to open it up. And the first thing I'm going to do is set the white balance. This is as shot and I wanna see what else Lightroom comes up with when I click cloudy. And it's going to warm up the picture just a bit, which is what I like. It brings in a bit more saturation, removes that blue tone. So I'm going to leave that there. And then I'm going to come down into my highlights and I'm going to decrease the highlights and I'm going to bring and open up the shadows, not completely, but to about 80. And if you look at the histogram, you'll see the tones begin to spread out more along the axis of the histogram. White, I'm going to bring in some more whites. And while, let's see, I've hit that clipping point, if I click on here, you'll see the red areas. It doesn't really matter to me. These aren't really important detail areas, but I wanted enough whites to brighten up the image some more. Black point, I will set the black clipping. I'm going to bring it down just slightly. Let's check what's being clipped. A few areas here in the quad bike. Again, not important to the picture, so I'm going to leave those points where they are. Lastly, I'm going to boost clarity to about 35, and we'll go back and we'll see before and after. Okay, so at this point, let me once again turn off those clipping indicators. And I'm going to now, well, I don't know, let's try, there we go. I'm now going to export it to Color Efex Pro. Those of you who have been watching my videos will know that in doing so, I'm going to edit a copy with the adjustments I've just made. Color Efex Pro will create, as it's thinking, a TIFF, here we go, a TIFF file down here in my film strip. And it is to this, whoops, there it is, where it is, it's jumping all over. It is to that file that the changes that I make in Color Efex Pro will be sent or will be exported back to once I'm done making my edits here. I'm going to get rid of this filter that has already populated and I'm going to start from scratch. I'm going to come back to over here to the list of all the filters in Color Efex Pro and I'm going to begin with Pro Contrast. I will scroll down and click on this little stack to open up all the presets and I will begin with Dynamic Contrast and see what changes. And I can toggle on and off the effect by clicking in this box. So I'm going to leave this here and add a few more filters and then I may do some adjustments to the individual sliders. Now to add a filter, I click on Add a Filter. I come back, I click back to go back to the list of all the filters. And I'm going to use one here that I don't use all that often, but when I do, when it works well. I'm going to use the detail extractor to really pull out the details in this photo. This is the default for, actually default settings for the default filter. And as I look at it, I think I'm going to tweak it a bit. It looks too HDR-ish to me. So I am going to bring down the values just to about, let's see, here. I'll leave the 6% on the contrast and saturation. As far as the effect radius, I'm going to change it to fine. You'll see that, I don't know if you can see the difference, there's large. No, it's really rather subtle on the screen, but I'm going to leave it here. It may be more noticeable if the level of the detail extractor was higher, but I typically use the fine radius. It's a much more subtle difference. The last filter I'm going to use is Darken, Light, and Center. I will click back here, click on the stack, and I will bring up the default preset for this filter. And you can do a lot of different things. This is basically a vignetting tool, and I can change the size of the center. I can move the center. I can make the borders darker or lighter. So on this, and I can change the shape of the center point. And on this one, I change the shape to number 2, excuse me, which is more oval. I left the center luminosity at 25 and the border at minus 50. And the center size I'm just going to increase just a bit because there's a large portion in here that I am interested in. And then placing center, I'm going to play around with this a little bit. I want more focus over here. And if you see what I just did, I think that was a pretty good move. I can come back to history and there we go. Normally the center is smack dab in the middle of the photo and I want it over to the right. So it highlights this area more with the cruise ship and the falling rain and takes some focus away from this area. So at this point, I'm going to click save. And the program is going to export these changes back to that existing TIFF file. And from there, I am going to do some additional adjustments in Lightroom using graduated filters and the radial brushes and or adjustment brushes and radial filters. So hang with me as this gets moved. Thinking. Okay, so there we go. So at this point, now I'm doing tweaking and I want to crop before I do anything else. And so I hit my crop tool and I know that I want to use the golden mean rectangle. So I'm going to come down here and click on the 1 by 1.618. And then I am just going to move this down. And what I'm aiming for is having this top line basically on the horizon line. And it's still leaving enough of the clouds in the picture for my liking. So I'm going to click done. And then I'm going to come back in and globally adjust the vibrance. I'm going to bring it down just a bit to about here. And then I'm also going to sharpen it. So I'm going to come into detail. And actually, I do have some presets over here, and I'm knowing I played around with these in my first go-round. I'm going to sharpen raw faces. So it's just a bit. Maybe I'll bring this down just a little bit. Okay, and then I'll close that panel. Now comes the fun local adjustments. And the first thing I'm going to do is I want to give a little bit of pop to the cruise ship. So I'm going to click on the adjustment brush. I'm going to size my brush by scrolling on my mouse wheel. And I'm going to zero out the effect before I choose the one I want. And my presets, I'm going to come down here and choose Enhance. And Enhance basically decreases exposure, highlights clarity and sharpness, and opens up the shadows. And you can see you can see the effect here. Let's make sure I've got that right. Actually, I don't, so let me back up. This is going to be the preset for the graduated filter. What I want in my adjustment brush, let me zero out. I just want to add a little warmth and increase the contrast. So let's boost that contrast up to about here. And now I'm going to paint in the boat. And you'll see the red mask so that I get it, you know, pretty close. And I will come and tick mask overlay so I turn it off. So now let's see what that was before. Okay, it's slight. Not as much as I'd like it. So let's come back here. I may be missing a little bit here of what I did before. Okay, let's try that. Okay, so we'll leave it there. It just gives a little bit of a punch. Now I'm going to add a graduated filter, and I want to do that to add some drama to more drama to the sky. So I'll click on, I'll click on the graduated filter tool, and I'm going to grab, drag down from the right, and I'm going to bring it to about here, and now I'm going to go in, and I'm going to again, zero out the effect, and I'm going to choose the enhance, and you'll see the difference right away. And this is the preset that decreases exposure and highlights and clarity and sharpness and opens up the shadows a bit, or it closes. This is so funny. Well, let's leave this here and see what happens. I did a lot of back and forth on this, so maybe this wasn't the right one that I used, and now maybe it's sky drama. Let's see. 100 highlights, clarity. This looks like this might have been the one that I used. So let's stay with this for now, okay? Bear with me, guys. Now I'm going to click done, and I want to add a new graduated filter. Let's make sure that I get this one right. I'm going to zero out, and I'm going to drag this one over here, and I want to burn and darken the sky here. So I am going to, let's try this again, another sky drama. And now I'm going to tweak this a little bit. And maybe, let's see, maybe I'm doing the wrong preset. So I'm going to adjust these sliders. Shadows, I want to about here. And saturation, about 14. And then sharpness, about here. Okay, we'll leave it there and click done. Let's see, what did I do next? I'm going to add a brush stroke to bring some warmth to this area that's in here. So let's click, and I'm just going to increase the temperature to about 65, according to my notes. And let's see how this works, because I'm really having a hard time here recreating what I did. I'm also going to add a new brush stroke back here to the mountains and the rain. So let's click and add the second brush stroke, and I'm going to increase the contrast just a bit, and the clarity I'm going to boost to about here, and then I'm going to increase the sharpness. So let's see what we've got here. Show selected overlay. Okay. And that just shows off the rain a bit more. And then the last, let's see, what else? I have a graduated filter to reduce the exposure here on the left, another graduated filter. Let's bring it down to about here. This is going to help focus attention more towards the middle. And this one I'm just going to decrease the highlights or reduce exposure. Okay, I'm going to reduce the exposure a bit. Okay, and then last but not least, let's click done. If you've stuck with me this long, I'm going to introduce a radial filter. Okay, whoops. And as I drag, I want to reposition. I click on the middle dot, and I want to move it about like this. And I'm going to increase the highlights in the inside to about here. So it brings some focus onto the cruise ship area. Okay, so let's see where we are. That is the final image. If I'm going to compare it to the one that I actually did and uploaded, and we'll see the difference. Well, there is a difference. So I think there's just, in playing around, Actually, I might like this second one better. But here is, let's go back to the original. Where is it? Now that's the original. So the before and the after. All right, guys, that was a little bit convoluted this week, but there were a lot of steps, and I appreciate it if you followed through the entire thing. For those of you watching this on YouTube, if you'd like to see more after before photos, galleries of after before photos, please visit my blog, visualventuring.com, and search for After Before Friday Forum. Thanks for watching, everyone.